Ayo.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello guys, we are from the group, group 4. I am Arfi Triawan.
I am Derby Ruchi Sundara.
I am Fikri Habib Ramadan.
I am Rizka Sebentar.
I am Rian Firman Pratama.
I am Suryani Lestari.
We will present on vlog or video vlog about tech. Let's find out.
The history of technology is the history of invention of tools and techniques, and is similar to the other sides of history. The term came from the Greek word techne, which means art and craft, with logos, which means speech and word. It was first used to describe applied arts, but now it is used to describe the advancement and changes around us. It starts with the beginning of life on Earth and goes until the founding of early modern technologies, such as computer and nuclear power. The era of technology started when wheel was invented, which is one of the most important technology in after it. More and more things were invented. Over the years, technology has revolutionized our world and daily lives. Technology has created amazing tools and resources, putting useful information at our fingertips.
3D printing is a process for creating or printing solid or three-dimensional objects from designs that are already available in digital format and made into 3D that are not only visible to the eye but can also be touched directly and have a certain form. Then how 3D printing machine works? First, 3D object model. 3D object models can be created using special software for 3D design model. First printer support examples such as SolidWorks, CATIA, DELCAM, and other. Second, printing process. If the design has been made, you can immediately print it on a 3D printer. Then the printing process starts. The length of this printing process depends on the size of the model. The printing process uses the basic principle of additive layer with a series of process machines that create the 3D design and start layering sequentially to build a virtual model which is automatic, combined to form a complete arrangement. And third, finishing. At this stage, you can fine-tune complex parts that could be caused by being of a size or a different size than desired. Additional technique to enhance this process can also use different material technique or color combination.
Furthermore, it is a real proof of the use of advanced technology in modern life, namely the presence of advanced technology in the sports called VAR, or Video Assistant Referee. VAR is a set of official football match that might help referees make decision by using replay footage only for clear and real error or serious incidents related to goals, penalties, direct card, or cases of mistaken identity when the referee warns or sends the wrong player from the team in action. The word assistant, in the middle of the abbreviation of the word, is indeed associated with the function of the technology in helping referees in seeing and observing the cues of a football match through a video. It is used to avoid cheating that usually occurs in the field. VAR technology is a solution that can help referees in making decision fairly to teams that are competing.
After that, let's talk about robot. Robot is a machine capable of carrying out a complex series of actions automatically, especially one programmable by a computer. Also, robot can be interpreted as a machine resembling a human being and able to replicate certain human movements and functions automatically. In this modern era now, robot is a really need to help human. Example, there are an industrial robot that helps human to make something goods in factory. And then the main robot, it can help human to clean the house. After that, there are a medical robot that help the doctor, especially surgeons, to perform the operations. But we as humans should not be lazy and defeated by robots. We have to keep working hard at our job. We as humans should think that this robot can make our work easier instead of taking away our work.
Now let's talk about cloud computing. Cloud computing is the on-demand availability of computing system resources, especially data storage and computing power, with hot delay active management by the user. Cloud providers typically use pay-as-you-go model, which can lead to unexpected operating expense if administrators are not familiarized with cloud pricing models. However, a proper use of cloud computing would be far more beneficial than by maintaining physical data centers. It can reduce costs from IT infrastructure, allow more data storage, and data backup along with ability to restore. Even if you're not part of the corporate or business, you're most likely already using cloud computing technology. Simple example of this can be Gmail. Basically, when you're using the email service, your data will be stored in the cloud, not in your computer. It will also be synchronized, so you can access it to your laptop or your smartphone as long as you're connected to the internet.
Okay, now let's talk about what geolocation is. Geolocation is a system for identifying the real-world geographic location of an object such as a radar, so cell phone, or computer terminal connected to the internet. Geolocation is closely related with the use of the more specific and meaningful positioning system, and not just a single set of coordinates, like example, street address and remote village location. Currently, there are many technologies that utilize this geolocation function, especially in developing applications. As example of use, when we get lost in an area and we don't know where to go, all you have to do is open a Google Maps application that has taken advantage of the geolocation function, and Google Maps will show you where you are. Maps can direct the direction of the route according to the destination. It is just one example of many use of geolocation.
These are the history and the example of technology in modern era. Thanks for watching this video. Goodbye.